Hello, writers. Welcome to my office for a Write With Me session. In this session, we will do 4 10-minute Pomodoro sprints. So this is a Write With Me for people that don't have a lot of time and they need to get some sessions in quickly, or for beginners who are just starting on the Pomodoro method and maybe they need to work on building up their attention span. I have another video that describes the Pomodoro method. I'll link to that in the description below. I don't want to spend a lot of time talking. I want to get directly into writing. We'll keep this as close to 1 hour as we can. That's why I chose 4 10-minute sessions, and we will have 4-minute breaks between the sprints. All right, so you see I'm using a tomato timer for the timer, so I'll time it for you. All you have to do is listen for the doorbell. All right, let's get started. right. Excuse me. The first session is over. That 10 minutes went really fast for me. How did it go for you? It flew by. I was working diligently the whole time. I didn't lose any focus because it was so short. And that's the purpose of a Pomodoro session, is that it's the amount of length of time, it's the length of time that you can stay in a high level of focus, a high level of productivity. You can ignore your email for 10 minutes. You can ignore your text messages for 10 minutes and all those other things that are pulling at your attention, and just focus on writing. Now, the breaks are really important too. Don't forget to take the breaks. Even if you feel like you're right in the middle of a sentence, like I was, take the break, because that feeling of, oh, I was right in the middle of something, is a benefit for you. Because when you go back to your next 10-minute session, you'll start like that, because you are in the middle of something. So you know exactly what to do next. It's not like you're starting from a blank page and you have to figure out how to get going. That's another benefit of Pomodoro. So the ability to focus for a long time and the ability to quick start at the next writing block. So welcome, any of you that are not familiar with the channel. If you're not a scientific writer, that's fine. You are totally welcome here. I'm a scientific writer. This channel is about scientific writing for the most part. But writers of other genres might find some useful information here too. Maybe you came here for NaNoWriMo. I guess that's how you say it. National Novel Writing Month. I don't write novels myself, but I read some. So we need you guys that write them, guys in a gender-neutral usage. I have my green tea here. I let it get a little cold, but it's still good cold. All right, so in the break, if you need to check your email, check your text messages, whatever, that's what these breaks are for. Stand up, stretch a little bit, get your shoulders loosened up. We have about 45 seconds before the next session starts. Now, I moved the timer off screen so that you're not looking at that. That's an important thing to do when you're writing, is put the timer where you can't see it, because you don't want your attention being sucked into the timer and watching the timer click down or waiting for that session to be over. It's good if it's a surprise, like that last one was for me. All right, we have about 15 seconds, so I'm going to get ready to start again. Go. right, hit save. Time for another break. That one went fast too. Can't believe how fast these 10-minute sessions go. 10-minute sprints, I should say. So the sprints make up the session. Sprints and the breaks make up the session. So what are you writing? Let me know down in the comments. I am actually working on some editing today. I am editing my transcripts from some of my previous YouTube videos so that I can update the closed captions so that they are accurate. Now you might say, that's not writing. You're not writing, you're editing. Well, you know, it's kind of part of the process. Editing is a necessary thing, and this kind of editing for me is kind of tedious. So if I do it in a Pomodoro style, it really helps me get it done. I'm a little bit behind on updating my closed captions, so I'm glad I'm doing this right now. Now, I really like regular editing. What's different about this is that YouTube takes my voice and it uses some kind of AI to make a transcript. And sometimes that transcript misunderstands some of my words, so I have to correct the words. But it doesn't have any sentences. It's one long string of lowercase words. So I have to go in and add the periods and capitalize the next sentence and add commas and semicolons and other punctuation. So it's a little bit tedious, but I think it's important for my audience to have that closed caption because, you know, a lot of my audience speaks English as a second language and they like to read it as I'm speaking. You know, maybe I don't speak as clearly as I need to for everyone that's watching. So I try to make sure I have those closed captions. So this is part of the process, is editing those and making them look nice. But I am curious what you're working on. If you're a scientific writer, maybe you are working on a thesis chapter or a dissertation chapter. Maybe you're working on a manuscript for a journal article. Maybe you're working on a grant proposal or a fellowship proposal. Maybe you're working on, you know, the text for a presentation that's coming up. You're going to give an oral talk. Yeah, any of those are fine. Just curious what you are doing. And let me know if you have any other tips on the Pomodoro method. So this is how I learned how to do it. This is how I like to do it. This tomato timer is really great because you can change the settings and it's free. There are lots of other ones on the internet. So just look for a timer that works for you. Or you can do it manually. That's fine. Or use your phone. All right, we have about 5 seconds, so I'm going to get ready to go again. All right. Okay. I have to make myself stop. I was going pretty well there, but 10 minutes goes so fast. I keep saying that, but it's true. All right. So another thing I'm curious about is, what do you write with? I like to write with Microsoft Word. I've used Google Docs, and I like it okay, but what I like about Word is I find it much easier to practice version control. So every day when I'm working on a file, I'll save it with the name of the file plus the date. So for example, well, you get the picture. So I put a date on each file, so every day I have a different version. And then if I need to go back to older versions, it's pretty easy to do that. It's also easy to do track changes with Microsoft Word. In Google Docs, it's a bit, you know, it has that capability, but to me it's not as smooth, it's not as easy to do. And leaving comments is not as easy in Google Docs, in my opinion. So that's what I like. You know, some people use LaTeX. I've never tried that one, so I don't know what that's like. Some people use Scrivener, and I've never tried that, but I'm curious because I am working on a book, and Scrivener is supposed to be excellent for people writing books because you can reorganize sections. So I may look into that later today. So let me know in the comments what you like to write with in terms of software. And how do you like to name your files? You know, when I was a grant writing consultant, we had a very specific file naming system and file tracking system. So we had a series of folders and subfolders, and that organization was really great. And I learned a lot about how to keep things organized in terms of files. So I don't follow that exact system now, but I learned from it and I developed a very organized system of folders, subfolders, files, file names. And it really makes things a lot easier to find later. Kind of running out of topics to talk about, but that's okay because we're running out of time in this break. We'll be coming up on our fourth and final 10-minute sprint. So get ready for that. We've got about 30 seconds. Let me know how this session went for you in the comments too. You know, and I'll try to respond to everyone. Have a little discussion going in the comments. And, you know, writing discussions are the best kind of discussions. Okay, so about 10 seconds. I'm going to take another sip of tea and then get ready. That's the start. Okay. Wow, that one went fast too. All right, that was 4 Pomodoro sessions. So you got 40 minutes of solid writing time and a few breaks. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it was helpful. Thanks for joining me today. Even though this is being recorded, you're not here live with me. Just the fact that knowing that the camera and you are watching me held me accountable. So I hope this helps you be accountable too. I'll see you next time, and happy writing.